Okay, let's do this. I got a bit too excited when I started wrapping this, and I didn't show the making of these big twine orbs, but I applied the same method as for the smaller ones. I played around with a bunch of different craft twines and strings. For the bigger, illuminated orbs, I used a thicker jute cord. It's really simple to make one. Let's go! Get a bowl and pour some strong clear liquid glue. Dilute it with a bit of water and stir to combine. You want this sticky solution a bit more concentrated for the bigger orbs, so maybe add less water than I did here. Soak the whole hemp rope in the bowl. Things can get messy, so make sure your working surface is protected. Inflate a balloon as big as your desired orb size and trap the air inside with a node. Start wrapping randomly and cover the balloon, but not fully. Apply just a bit of pressure to remove the excess of the sticky solution. If you want to place Christmas lights inside, you need a bit of extra space to place them, so do this. At the end of the balloon where you made a knot to trap the air inside, leave a bit of uncovered space. It should look something like this and should be big enough to fit your hand. Twist and turn till you get the density you like. Keep in mind that the first and last parts need to be tucked under some layers of twine. If you feel there's still a lot of liquid on the rope, you want to go for this method, where you remove even more of the glue. This way, you extract all the thread from the gluey mixture first by applying more pressure and then start wrapping. Hang them somewhere where there's not a lot of moisture in the air and do your best in waiting 24 hours. The next day, cut the hanging thread and punch the balloon with a needle or something. Place your favorite light string inside. The best way is to turn it on before to see how they look while you distribute them evenly and cling them to the orb's margins. You need to know that they will be okay as long as the room you display them in is not very moist. Moisture softens them in time, but even so, they should be alright for a few days in a row. Check out my other DIY Christmas decorations tutorials. Cheers!